Rick Hill pulling onto the Speedway. He'll be told to catch up to the field because we're going to go green next time, I believe. Yep. Your flagman is giving them a one to go. Vic will start to the tail of the field, I believe.
Here we go.
Bloomquist, Madden, row one. Ogle Jr. and Owens, row two. King and Ligon, row three. Vic Hill and Glenn Elliott, row four. You see the chalk line in turn four. That's where they'll hit the gas. You'll see the green flag. We're racing here at Bulls Gap. Bloomquist to the lead. We got one in trouble. It looks like Ryan King in the 1G car got a little bit crossed up. They're three wide into turn four, back at the tail of the field. Bloomquist out front, followed by Madden, Ogle Jr., and then Owens. Bloomquist with a couple second advantage over Madden. I believe they all got a little bit crossed up on that first corner. Glenn Elliott slides a little high, going to allow, well, let's see. I believe we got Brian Ligon in the four car, slow on the backstretch. Caution is out. We're under lap number four. Brian Ligon out of Augusta, Georgia, pulling it into the infield. No courtesy laps for a flat under heat race conditions. Inside only the Dennis Ogle Jr., Owens, King, Elliott, and Hill. Here we go, green flag back out. Ogle Jr. gets a good jump on the outside. He'll move to second on the outside of Madden. Madden slips up a little bit and bottles up Owens as well. Still holding off Vic Hill. But back out front, Billy Ogle Jr. not letting Bloomquist get away this time. Bloomquist with only just a couple car length advantage. Billy Ogle Jr. in that new chassis, able to hold on to your leader. Flag in the air for your leader, Scott Bloomquist. Works it back through three and four, coming to the line. And Scott Bloomquist will take heat race number one. He will start inside row one for your feature event. 12,000 to win here at the Scorcher. Your finishing order was Scott Bloomquist.
Did Owens get to second?
Jimmy Owens, yes.
Jimmy Owens second. Billy Ogle Jr. third. The 1C of Kenny Collins. To his outside will be your points leader in the Bob Series. The 5H of Jeremy Hines. And starting in row four will be the 38 of Derek Fisher, running second in Battle Bluegrass Points out of Columbus, Indiana. Green flag out. Quick start for Davenport. Buckingham going to look to the inside of Wolfenbarger. Wolfenbarger will hold him off. The 10 of Ogle going to try to cut down to the inside, but he'll hold on to the fourth spot. Now Ogle to the inside of Wolfenbarger. For the second spot, Davenport already pulling away. Cynthia Buckingham slides high, allows Ogle to get by. He again slides a little high. Kenny Collins in the 1C works underneath him. Whoa! Tried to slide up in front. Buckingham there. Everybody's going to save it and keep racing. Davenport almost to the tail of the field. He's got over a straightaway lead in a 10-lap heat race. He is lapping in the 12th, last lap, 12.171 for Davenport, faster than his qualifying time. White flag being showed for your leader. Davenport had a little bit of a difficult time trying to work his way past the 38 of Fisher. It's a battle in a battle there between the 5H and the 38 of Fisher. Jonathan Davenport, your heat race winner. He's followed by Jeff Wolfenbarger, Chad Ogle, Kenny Collins, and Shannon Buckingham, and Jeremy Hines and Derek Fisher. So Davenport will start outside road number one. Familiar sight, Bloomquist and Davenport on a front of Dale McDowell. Mark Vineyard in the four car. That's the white number four. And Tommy Kerr scheduled and not able to make it out. Jimmy Mack in the 23 car. He's dropped tail on the field. Donald McIntosh in the 7M car will start inside row three. The 20W of Chad White. And here we go, getting ready to go. Green flag in the air. McDowell using that high side, works it up. Rambo slides high. Rambo in the two car slides high. He'll drop back to fourth. First lap will go in the books. It'll be McDowell. Weiss, Franklin, and McIntosh.
Vineyard's not picking up. Can't score Vineyard, he's not picking up.
McDowell with about a 10-car length advantage over Ricky Weiss. Then it's a whole bunch back to Mark Vineyard and Donald McIntosh. Next time by will be cross flags halfway down for your leader, Dale McDowell. The third position between McIntosh and Vineyard. Vineyard still has it. McIntosh trying to work to the inside. Rambo right there as well. Vineyard able to hold him off. McIntosh good bite on the inside, but that high side momentum tough to work around. Vineyard keeping him pinched down through three and four. Back out front. McDowell has Weiss all over him as McDowell's in traffic. Weiss going to look to the inside. McDowell shuts the door through one and two. Dale McDowell trying to work around the 23 of Jimmy Mack. And that was your checker flag lap. Dale McDowell, your winner of heat race number three. He will start third overall tonight, be followed by Ricky Weiss in the seven car, Mark Vineyard in the 4V, Donald McIntosh the seven, the two of Dennis Rambo Franklin, Chad White in the 20W, and Jimmy Mack in the 23.